Congressman Matt Gaetz, member of the House Judiciary Committee. And first of all, Congressman, sometime around 5 o'clock, the House Intel Committee is going to vote whether or not to release this memo. Even if they vote to release it, it won't be for a couple of days till we see it. But was there anything in the memo, and you have read it, and I know you can't be specific about it, but was there anything in the memo that might have led Mr. McCabe to either resign or be dismissed?
Unfortunately, I can't answer that question because it could have potentially confirm or deny what was in the memo. I will say that based on what has been publicly available, the text messages, particularly between Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, referencing meetings in Andy's office to discuss their insurance policy to save the American people right. from Donald Trump, that to me was a sufficient basis
well,
for has, Mr.
McCabe
to move
on. Well, has it been confirmed that the Andy referred to in the text is Andrew McCabe?
Well, it seems very obvious to me, based on the totality of the facts, that that is, in fact, the case. Mr. McCabe may have a different viewpoint, but I think that would be very hard to maintain in a factual inquiry.
You have friends in the House Intel Committee, and you've read the memo, et cetera. Do you think it is going to be released? Is that the decision to which they're going to come?
I do. I think that Chairman Nunes and the Republican members of the Intelligence Committee have done a fantastic job. Remember, this memo culminates a year-long investigation that they've been on to ensure that the FBI and Department of Justice would be free of the type of political bias that so many of us are so concerned about.
But
these
you know,
are their
all
findings.
Weekend,
these are the facts.
Congressman, forgive me for interrupting, but we've been hearing this drumbeat from Democrats and the mainstream media, for that matter, that there really isn't a bias at the FBI and the DOJ, and you Republicans are beating up on fine institutions. We had Eric Holder chime in with his tweet or text message. He said FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe is and has been a dedicated public servant. He went on to talk about bogus attacks on the FBI and DOJ. Your response?
It was on Eric Holder's watch that politics infected the top levels of the FBI and the Department of Justice. Eric Holder did us no favors by bringing politics into these hallowed institutions that we've got to be able to rely on to be unbiased no matter who is in power. And so I think his comments are entirely misplaced. And look, it's not just Republicans who are saying that this is troubling. It's the text. It's the actual words right. that these people are using, talking about an insurance policy against the president. That undermines our democracy.
These texts and
the
texts were between Mr. Strzok and Lisa Page, who was a lawyer at the FBI. First of all, there's Andrew McCabe. There's Peter Strzok. But Andrew McCabe was being investigated for possible conflicts of interest over his wife's use of Democratic funds while he was leading a Clinton email investigation. Now, it's true that he wasn't doing the investigation at the time his wife was running, but do you think there was a conflict of interest there significant enough for him to step down?
I think that Andrew McCabe is stepping down likely not as a consequence of his wife's activities, but of his own. And whether or not politics influenced the decisions he made will be up for history to judge. But I think that the evidence is laid out pretty clearly that you had a group of people, McCabe, Strzok, and Page, who hated Donald Trump. And they allowed that personal belief to manifest in actual yeah. decisions, actual investigations, and things happened that should not have happened. And I think when we release this memo, we're going to have a very clear understanding of the abuses and the bias that has infected these institutions.
Okay, and there is a long list. I mean, for those in the media who say there's no evidence of bias, all you have to do is go into the Fox News website and you'll see a complete list of some of the people. We didn't even talk about Bill Priestep from the FBI's mm-hmm. counterintelligence or Bruce Orr from the Justice Department, whose wife was working on that Trump memo. So there are a lot of people involved here. Matt Gaetz, great to see you, sir. Thank you very much.